Good evening, everyone. We're going to try and start right on time here. It's a nice full program for you that we're excited to share with you this evening, with all the work that the hard work that the students have put into this concert, some throughout the entire year and some just within a couple months or so. So we're very excited to get this evening going, and we're going to start first with a word of prayer. So let's bow our heads, please. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this time that we can gather together and hear the music prepared by these students and the directors, and just the talent that they possess and that they're going to be sharing with the audience tonight. I ask that you be with each one of them, and we also just thank you for the gift of music and what that brings with having everybody together here and hopefully being blessed and having fun by it, what they hear tonight as well. How about to be a fun evening and just be with everybody in this room. In your name we pray, amen. We are going to start first with our middle school advanced band. This is anybody in grades 6 through 8 who has been playing their instrument for at least a year from beginning band days. And we're going to be doing two pieces for you. The first one is Zigzag. It's your typical middle school sounding piece, very upbeat, fast, loud, all those good things to start off the concert. And then following that, we're going to be playing Celtic Air and Dance, which has two different styles to it with Celtic melodies. Involved. The first part showcases the woodwinds a bit more, it's on the slower side, and then it picks up the tempo a bit more, showcasing more of the percussion and some of the brass as well. So I hope you enjoy the middle school performance today. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, sometimes we have some transitions that we have to do between each ensemble because they actually haven't been in the space before performing, so a little bit of rearranging here. But we're welcoming the orchestra up to the stage now, and as you can tell, I'm a little bit of a talker, but I've been told to keep it short because of time and it's a long program. But I do want to talk about orchestra a little bit before they start. It's actually started off as a string ensemble first, and it's been around for many years, and then this year I wanted to make it a goal to make it into a full orchestra. And as you can see behind me, it's actually not a full orchestra yet. It's the beginnings of it. We're still missing some key parts in there, like we have a timpani, but we don't have all the other percussion. We have one trumpet instead of three. Depending on what Mr. Wiedemann plays, sometimes we only have one flute or one low brass, that kind of thing. So we've been making it work, though, and they've been doing an amazing job that you're going to be hearing very shortly here. So they've been working very hard. We also have had limited rehearsals to prepare these pieces, but it's okay because they're awesome and you're going to love them. They're going to sound awesome tonight. But we are going to start off first with a classical piece for you. It's Mendelssohn's Fifth Symphony, which is also known as the Reformation Symphony. And it's the fourth movement that we're going to be playing for you today. And it has the theme of Mighty Fortress is Our God. And you'll hear that throughout the entire symphony piece that we're doing, this movement that we're playing for you today. So we're going to start off with that one. Next up is Cumberland Cross. This one, I am proudly actually going to say this. They've only had about 3 rehearsals to learn this, and they mastered it. It's actually a personal favorite of mine. It has a nice little Wild West kind of rodeo feel to it, a lot more upbeat than other like classical kind of pieces can sound sometimes, like what we just played. Even though it's very, very powerful, this one has a lot more of a slow opening, and then it goes into this really kind of, like I said, Wild West theme. So it's a lot of fun, something a little bit different. And a short little piece in between the 2 big pieces. And our final piece is Millennium, and I think I can speak for pretty much everybody behind me that's the overall favorite of the set that we've actually even learned all year, I think, too. Millennium is a longer piece, and it sounds almost like it's from a movie score, but it's not. It's an original piece of work, and there's 3 different sections in it. It starts off with like a heroic kind of theme. It's presented mostly in the brass, but also some percussive elements as well. And then it goes into a lyrical, slower section that the cellos have the melody in. And then it ends with a very powerful, expressive ending that personally has my personal favorite thing in the whole entire piece, which is a whole triplet section within the strings and also some of the woodwinds as well. That's really fun to listen to and have them play, I think, as well. Hopefully it's fun to play. But they do a really nice job with this one. It's a favorite of the group, and I hope you enjoy it as well.
Thank you. It is so wonderful that you came out to support us. And it simply would not be an Adventist gathering or any kind of a gathering here at our school without having an offering. So we have some really cute black hats that we're going to pass during the jazz band. Thank you so much for how much you have supported throughout the years. This means so much to us, and we really, really appreciate your help with our budgets and with being able to buy a piano and buy a string bass and buy some instruments that we needed for the band and add on bells. You just have been so supportive. So thank you again, and we hope that you enjoy the rest of the show.
My nicely designed rows are all a mess right now, but it's okay. So again, it's going to take a little while to get transitioned for each group. But we're going to start with our jazz band as we take the offering. Jazz band is one of my highlights of the week. I think I speak for almost everybody behind me as well, if not everybody, that it's theirs as well. I've mentioned this before, but I'm going to restate it because it's actually their first time doing a real actual performance except for Fall Fest and what was featured during Christmas concert. But jazz band used to be a big deal at Spencerville, maybe like 10-ish years ago or so. Then it fizzled out, and the ensemble just kind of disappeared. And then last year, in the spring, around March, I had several students ask me if we could revive it and bring it back, because they really liked their instrument, they wanted to try a different style, and they were interested in just starting jazz band back up again. So I wasn't going to say no to that. So last year in March, we started jazz band up, and I don't remember how many we had in that starting group. It's definitely grown since then. But they ended up being a hit in the spring concert, and we continued it all throughout this year, and have been really doing quite well with any performance opportunity that they have. So everybody behind me here, it's not a class, it's not a grade, it's basically like a club, if you will, of anybody who wants to play that enjoys their instrument and their music and creating just music together. It just really is formed from the dedication of these students. So it's a fun set that we're going to be having for you guys. We're going to start with the Muppet theme song, and then we'll follow some pieces after that. Thank you.
Thank you.
It's always actually a surprise for me sometimes too what they do, because it's all about improv, right? Improv. So Devin had an improv solo there, and then obviously you heard the drum set as well in that little bridge area there. But it's fun because they always play something different. I don't know what to expect, and it sounds really awesome. So our last piece is Ain't No Mountain High Enough. I hope you enjoy.
So the best part about this job is that I get to work with Lisa Frelick. And she was my student. She was my Gretel in our very first play. And I love working with my students. Wonderful job, wonderful job. This is our ringers. So the group you heard before is more of our underclassmen, freshman, sophomore. And this is more of our upperclassmen, bell choir.
Thank you.
I think they need more time. So I'll just tell you a little bit about the bells while they're setting up. The largest one you see down there was 5,200. And so we were able to raise the money for that one. And that is part of what we call the sixth octave. The whole thing you see here is worth half a Tesla. Just thought you'd know.
Thank you.
So the last one is praise him with cymbals and drums. And I was just reading this in Psalms 150, and that when we are all returned to heaven together, we will make the most joyous noise, the most beautiful music, cymbals and drums and all kinds of instruments in our voices, singing praises to God. So I hope you will think of that wonderful day when we play this.
Okay, as the band is making their way up, I noticed one of the rows kind of got absorbed into the other row, so give us a second first to fix that, and then I'll talk to you guys for a little bit. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, this is where I have notes now because it's getting later and I'm getting tired. So that was just the Phantom of the Opera medley. And next up is Pirates of the Caribbean. And what I always tell my audience, or the audience that's listening to us at a spring concert, is it's not so much about where the music comes from, but what's learned in the process in the pieces. And that's usually why I choose them, is to teach them something new. So with Pirates of the Caribbean, there's a lot of different meter changes for one. One of them is a 12/8 meter, which they haven't played in before. So it gave them a new experience to try that. And right off the bat in the arrangement, it has three different layers of rhythms happening at the same time. And that was really hard to kind of match up because everybody has to listen to each other while also focusing on their own layer of rhythm. The other big thing is triplets that happens throughout this a bit. It happens kind of naturally as part of a 12/8 time signature, but you'll hear it kind of speeding up at times and slowing down. If you're familiar with the music, you'll recognize some of the tunes, but it really gave them a nice challenge to try some new time signature changes, another medley as well where it changes up with the tempo, and it's a nice and fun little piece. Thank you. I have to give them talking breaks for me to talk, for them to rest. It's a lot. It's a workout. It's a workout. The next piece that we're doing is actually, it brings back some nostalgia from the past. I don't know how many parents out there would recognize this, but we're playing the Great Locomotive Chase. And that was something that when the current seniors played at last, they were in eighth grade in middle school. So we brought it back as kind of a nice little way to kind of round out their musical education before they leave. And it has some significance to it because it was my first year here that I taught. We had 13 in the high school band. So we took the high school band and combined it with the middle school and formed a big ensemble. So I don't know how many were here to hear that before, but we thought it'd be kind of nice to bring it back and have it played with all of high school, including the seniors that obviously played it when they were in middle school, and just showing the growth and talent of that. Fun fact, they only just got it on Thursday. This is another workout piece. A lot of these pieces that we're playing are. And the story behind the Great Locomotive Chase, it's a long story that we don't have time for right now to get into. But long story short, they're creating a train. Everything with their sound that they're creating, their technique, what the percussion's doing, what they're doing themselves with techniques in their instrument, but also with their breathing, they're literally creating a train. And it's actually based off of a true story. Back in the Civil War time, some of the soldiers captured a train, took off with it, and the other side was trying to chase after them. So the whole thing is a train, essentially a runaway train, while other people are trying to catch it, eventually slowing down at the end. So what you should be hearing, hopefully, is us creating a train for you, and you can pretend you're on the ride if you want. But it's really cool. It has a lot of dynamic changes, and it's just a nice one to bring back for the last concert for the seniors.
Thank you.
Okay, so second to last piece is How to Train Your Dragon. And this one we actually performed 2 years ago in spring concert of 2021. But when you hear 2021, it kind of connects to 2020, which we all know is the COVID time period, especially in the height of COVID. So we performed it, but it was a recording. We had the students come to the auditorium. They were spaced out still, and we recorded it for our videoed spring concert because we couldn't have an audience at that time. So it's time to bring it back for an audience to enjoy instead of just through a screen. It's another one that we're bringing back for nostalgia purposes. It's a personal favorite of mine. Has a lot of triplets in it. Listen for those. It's my favorite thing in the world. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
last piece. I can't believe it's already been 2 hours. You guys are troopers, so are they. It's been a long night, but full of great music, so hopefully you've been enjoying your time tonight. Our last piece is Curtain Call, which kind of speaks for itself. It's usually the ending. It's actually in a Broadway kind of style, so it's as if the curtains are closing. It has a little bit of a cartoonish vibe to it. It's a lot of fun. It's in cut time. It definitely incorporated a lot of different techniques that the band hasn't encountered before. You're going to see the percussion doing a lot of fun different elements that you'll hear throughout, even a whistle, things like that, that just kind of bring out different styles to it. And it's just a really fun piece to close out the concert tonight. So thank you again for coming, and I hope you enjoy Curtain Call. We're not done yet. We have some things to hand out to some students that are very deserving, called awards. So please stay tuned for the awards ceremony, please.
So this we promise to keep it quick because it's 8:59. And I know somebody who's really tired. I'd like to bring down Emily Flores. She is our choir director for the high school, and we would like to personally invite you to the choral concert on the 16th at the Spencerville Adventist Church. And she's going to be giving an award for the top choral musician this year.
Okay, hello everyone. As Jane Lanning said, I am the high school choir director here, and it has been a wonderful experience this year, and picking one of these students has been very difficult, as all of them are very wonderful and incredibly talented. Aren't all our students talented over here? Let's all give them a round of applause. So the student that we have chosen for the Choral Award is not just a wonderful singer, but is also very talented in many areas of their lives. This student is a wonderful string player. This student is a wonderful brass player. Forgot what it was called for a second. This student is a wonderful, excellent ringer as well. And most importantly, this student has shown the true elements of being a team player in an ensemble. So without further ado, the choral award goes to Giancarlo Celestia.
The next award we're handing out is for jazz band. And again, as I mentioned before, it was something that used to exist. And the last time it was actually given was 2016. So it shows you how long it's been since it's fizzled out. But now it's back. And the recipient, I need to get my stuff. The recipient of the jazz award is somebody I look for that has the enthusiasm needed to be in the jazz band just to have fun with the music, but also somebody who loves their instrument. This person has also been somebody I've witnessed practicing to try and get the correct rhythm and really just putting their heart and soul into the music and really just enjoying their time. They've been dedicated to attending rehearsals, which, like I said before, isn't mandatory. It's just if you're free, you come, basically. And so they've shown that dedication. And all around just has that eagerness to play and the spirit that I look for in a jazz band member. So I'm very excited to announce, finally, after such a long break, the recipient of the Jazz Award this year goes to Sky Standish. recipients of these awards get like a little award like this, but we have to get their name still engraved, so we're not handing it to them yet, but they'll get it eventually.
I would like to invite my seniors that I'm losing in my Spencerville Ringers this year, seven of the 13. Please come down, seniors. So, Giancarlo, you rang for how many years out of high school? Yes. 3 years. Grady? Two? John? Jonathan? Two? Three? Two? Four? Four. Okay. Here's a medal for each one of you to let you know how much I love you. And before you go, sorry. Before you go, I would like to give this year's Bell Ringer Award. This is usually, too, the most selfish bell ringer. I really groom them to be selfish bell ringers. I'll take the four bells. I'll ring with my toes. They're wonderful. This year's Bell Award goes to Hannah Soper.
You guys might as well stay down because you guys have orchestra and band. You guys are in all. You guys are in everything. These guys have like they've been in every single ensemble. Might as well stay around. All right, so we're gonna do the orchestra award next. And this is somebody who again has shown that dedication. You're gonna hear me saying that word a lot. Somebody who has been a leader and just also looking for opportunities outside of SAA to even play in ensembles. A very, very strong player, very motivated to continue to succeed on their instrument, and just an absolute fantastic musician, and I'm sure you've seen their talent throughout the 4 years of high school. So the orchestra award I would like to present to Gabby Apola. Where is she? Yeah, we forgot to mention that also each student that gets these big awards are also going on plaques that hang in the Hall of Fame area where you see all those pictures in the hallway. So they're getting their names engraved on those. There's actually another orchestra award I'd like to hand out today as well. Another person who's equally deserving as well, has been a very hard worker over the past 4 years in strings and now orchestra. And just the dedication and responsibility and just the enthusiasm and again always searching for things to do outside of the SA ensemble and trying to do other bigger things as well with auditions and whatnot. Just a strong player, been there for the section the whole entire time. So I'm very proud to also announce this award for Megan Nashed. Yeah. And of the ensemble awards, the last one is also the John Philip Sousa Award, which is the band award. And again, I said the word dedication all the time. Dedication is a huge thing. And something I also look for is the growth over the years they've been in the ensemble, just seeing where they start, where they end up, just the talent. With this particular student, they're even somebody that I've gotten to the point where when we perform, a lot of people come up to me afterwards and are like, did you see what they were doing? And like they have their eyes, like the audience just has their eyes glued on them. And it's just like a show stealer. Just the talent is just amazing that has been developed in the student. I'm going to be very sad to see them leave next year. They are a senior. But I'm very, very excited and proud to announce the Sousa Award to Grady Noble.
So, another number of years ago, there was a student that went here. She was actually the great-great-granddaughter of Ellen G. White. She was one of my students, Pam White, a great-great-great, I believe. And her grandfather decided to start a fund that would just be for recognizing students who really, really wanted to be involved in music, who were involved in music as much as they possibly could, and then even outside of that day, they wanted to be involved with music. And they've just shown exceptional abilities in what they do. And so we have started a perpetual plaque. I believe it started in, it was in the 90s, I believe, in 1998 or 7 or something like that. And this girl was one of them. And so she was one of the recipients of the White Memorial Award. And so this year's White Memorial Award, they go onto a perpetual plaque in our case out here that you all see. And this year's, where is it? Here it is. There's so many now. So many of these kids are so good. Oh, okay. And then, so this is like the third plaque. We've done so many. So this year's award goes to Jonathan Moats.
Are you guys not proud of art students? Oh. I am continually amazed at all that you guys have produced today, and thank you to our music teachers and music department. They work so hard for our students and their development. Let's give them one more round of applause. I hope your hearts are as filled as mine is today and that you can go home blessed. Let's all stand as we pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for these student musicians and their teachers and the praises that they've sent up in forms of sound waves. And we thank you, Lord, that they have shown us that when you work together and you play on the same notes, and the same pitches, and the same harmonies, and the same keys, that you can produce such amazing things. Thank you for these lessons that we've learned through these musicians, that when we work together, and when we are in step with your will, Lord, that we can do amazing things as well. Please help us to go home blessed and safe. In your most precious name we pray. Amen. Amen. Happy evening, everybody.
Band members, I need you guys to help. Sorry. So take care of your instrument first, and then take some chairs and stands and percussion stuff and take it back. Just watch the crowds, please.